Hello everyone. Today I will be talking about what to do in case of minor injuries and cuts and wounds in children. In children, it's very common to get minor injuries and wounds when they're running around in the park, they fall on the road, they hit themselves or cut themselves with something at home. Firstly, the injured part should be cleaned thoroughly. You should wash your hands with soap and water and place your child's injured part or the wound under running water. If the injury has happened in a dirty place, say outdoors in the playground or on the road, or you are not sure where it happened, then better to use some mild soap also to clean the area. Use the soap and the surrounding skin liberally, but on the wound be a bit careful, use little amounts and avoid the soap going directly into the injured part. After you do this, if the wound is still bleeding, then you take some clean cotton cloth or some gauze and apply firm pressure over the bleeding part over the wound for 10 to 20 minutes. In most cases, the bleeding will stop within this time. After the bleeding stops, apply a thin layer of any antibiotic cream which you have at home. It could be sofromycin, mupimed, T-Bact, or anything which is available at home. In case you don't have an antibiotic cream, you can even apply a layer of Vaseline at home till somebody goes and buys the antibiotic cream from the chemist. I would recommend those who don't have a simple antibiotic cream at home, please purchase one, because in children of all age groups, some injuries will keep happening and it's a basic part of the first aid. A few things which should not be done. Some parents, they panic and they will apply some turmeric or some sugar if the wound is bleeding. Please don't do that. Little bleeding will not cause any problems. First, you clean the injured part thoroughly and later you just apply some antibiotic cream. Turmeric, sugar, these are not known to be helpful and they may even cause some infections and some contamination of the wound. After this is done, if it's a minor injury, you can leave it open. If you feel that, you know, the child may keep touching the injured part or may fall on it again, or it's a bit bigger, then you can apply a band-aid or just wrap a roller gauze around it or put some gauze and fix it with some surgical tape or micropore, whatever you have available at home. You should not use plain dry cotton directly on the wound because it may stick to the injured part and the wound part, and those small pieces of cotton may cause infection. In case you do that, supposing in an emergency you quickly have some cotton at home and you put it over the wound, then later you just wash it off with water. Also, the use of Dettol and Sablon is really not required. Soap and water works much better and it will not cause any irritation of the skin as well. Now, what are the conditions in which you should rush to an emergency immediately? If the bleeding does not stop even after 15 to 20 minutes of applying good pressure over the injured area, if you feel the wound is very deep, if the margins of the wound skin are quite separate, in this case, the child may require some stitches or some surgical glue or a better dressing which can be done at the hospital. In case you have any doubts, you are not sure, you feel the injury may be a bit deep or not, then always better to pay a visit to the emergency. The doctors will quickly have a look. Another question most parents have is whether to give tetanus shot after any injury. So in children, we are giving them tetanus vaccine at 1.5 months, 2.5 months, 3.5 months, then booster doses at 18 months, 5 years and 10 years. These doses of tetanus are part of the DPT vaccine. So if your child is getting his or her regular shots at the pediatrician's office, then you need not worry about the tetanus shot till at least 10 years of age, unless it's a very bad road traffic accident or a very major injury. In that case, anyways, you'll be going to the hospital and they will take that call. But for minor injuries, if your child is has been receiving his or her regular vaccinations, no need for a tetanus shot. Sometimes after a few days or after 1 or 2 days, you'll notice that there is some pus or purulent discharge coming from the injury site. There is redness around the skin. There is swelling around the skin. The child develops a fever the next day. Then these may be signs that the wound is getting infected. So please visit your pediatrician in that case. The child may require some antibiotics and maybe a more thorough dressing. Some infection has probably set in. Most of these superficial injuries may heal without any scarring or without leaving behind any mark. But if you feel that some mark is being left, the injury has healed, but you can see a dark mark which is present over the injured area, you can do some things to prevent the scar from being more darker, and with time it will become a little lighter. For this, what you should do is apply sunscreen over the injured part, over the healing part. Sunscreen should be of SPF more than 50. It should be applied 20 minutes before outdoor exposure. Now, outdoor exposure just does not mean going out in the sun. Anytime your child is moving outdoors, even in a car or in the school bus or going to school, please apply the sunscreen 20 minutes prior to that. And it should be reapplied every 4 hours if the child is still outdoors. There are certain creams also available. You can ask your pediatrician or a dermatologist, or if the child has required sutures, you can ask the surgeon for those creams. They can be rubbed and massaged into the scar tissue. That will also help in the scar from becoming very dark. In fact, most of the scars may be very light with time. Now, these interventions, some parents will just do these interventions for 1 or 2 weeks and then they will say that the scar is very dark. No, these interventions have to be done for a period of 6 months to 1 year. That is the time taken for the scar to completely form. Hope these things help the next time your child has any injury.